Hello, good morning to all of you. Today in this video we are going to discuss the topic Hamilton's principle. This question is very important for PG semester 1 students from examination point of view. So let us start. First of all, we will see what is Hamilton's principle. In the second part, we will deduce the Hamilton principle. Actually, Hamilton's principle tells us that out of so many possible paths or available paths, which path is actual? Suppose we are here and we want to reach at Q. This is suppose P. It is not mentioned here, but you can understand it. This is P. So we have to move from P to Q. You can go from this to this straight, either by curve or by another curve. So there may be so many paths. But which path is actual? Let's learn from Hamilton's principle. So what Hamilton's principle states, I am reading here. According to Hamilton's principle, the path actually traversed by a conservative holonomic dynamical system from time t1 to t2 is one over which the integral of the Lagrangian between limits t1 and t2 is stationary. That is, the time integral of the Lagrangian is extremum. You are familiar with the term extremum. Actually, this is when we see either maximum or minimum, in place of we use one word, extremum. This statement can be written as mathematically integration t1 to t2, this one, L dt, L is the Lagrangian, integration with respect to time is equal to extremum, J extremum, where J is the extremum value of the time integral of the Lagrangian and is known as Hamilton's principle. Okay, equation 1 may be written as del. So when you use del variation, it means this is extremum, so its differentiation will be 0, and that is where the right side is 0, because here del is used. So equation 1 and 2, what is the difference? Here variation is taken, here no variation, here extremum, here 0. Del is the variation symbol. This principle helps us to distinguish the actual path from the neighboring path. As I told you, we have so many possible paths. So out of so many possible paths, which will be the actual path? So in order to distinguish the actual path from the neighboring paths, this principle, means Hamilton's principle, helps us. Now we are going to deduce the Hamilton's principle. Let us consider that the conservative holonomic dynamical system moves from P to Q, where P and Q are initial and final configurations. Okay, this is your P. P is not mentioned here. You can understand it P, and this is Q. At time T1, we are here. At time 2, we are here. Let PRQ, this one, straight, be the actual path, and this path, and another path PR double dash, this path. Okay, out of infinite number of possibilities, it is assumed that del t must be 0 at end points, here at Q and here at P. At T1, the particle must be at P1. At T2, particle must be at Q. at T1, particle must be at P, and T2, particle must be at Q. Del R must be equal to 0 at endpoint, that is point P and Q are fixed in space. Okay. Let S0, let so many forces act upon the system represented by F. Force means mass into acceleration from Newton's second law. Here acceleration is not written by A, but A means rate of change of velocity. Velocity means rate of change of displacement. So R is the displacement, double dot here. You can see double dot means double differentiation of displacement gives acceleration. So Fi is equal to Mi Ri double dot. From D. Lambert's principle, as you have seen in previous videos, you have read D. Lambert's principle, which is equal to Fi minus Mi Ri double dot D dot del Ri is equal to 0. Now we resolve the bracket. Fi dot del Ri, see here. And Mi Ri dot double dot del Ri here. So it's equal to 0. Now Ri double dot del Ri, you can write this as it. So when you solve this, you will get this one. If there is a little variation along the actual and neighboring paths, means there is no much difference, little variation, then del Ri is equal to Ri dot minus Ri, say del Ri, little variation, then d by dt del Ri is equal to this one. Okay, d by dt Ri dot Ri prime minus d by dt minus Ri here. So on differentiation, after differentiation, we get this one. You know the differentiation, so there will be no problem. Del dRi by dt del Ri dot. Here primes have been used for neighboring paths. Using equation 3 and 2 may be written as, so we use equation 3 and 2, we can write this one. We come to this point here. Okay, so this is equation 2 and this is your equation 3. This one. So with the help of equation 3, equation 2 may be written as this one. Using FM equation, now if once you get this one, so this value is taken in equation 1, Mi Ri double dot del Ri. This actually, this part, we have calculated this part. Now we are going to set here. Equation 1 becomes this. And we solve this Fi del Ri minus Mi d by dt, this one, and this can be written as half. So again Fi del Ri dot del Ri minus this minus, see here, this minus and this minus becomes plus. So on resolving the bracket, and this term, this whole term is taken right side, so minus, here it will be plus. And now on solving this one as it is, after solving we will get this one, and it is equation 5. But here you can see Fi del Ri, this is the virtual work. Why? Because force into actual displacement, it force dot actual displacement is real work, but del Ri is virtual displacement, so it is virtual work. Work done by the force Fi acting during displacement del Ri, del W, say. And this one is kinetic energy, this one. This one is kinetic energy of the system represented by del T. Therefore, equation 5 becomes del W, this one, del W work done, this is del T kinetic energy. So del W plus del T is equal to, as it is, integrating above equation between the limits T1 and T2 we get. Now we are going to integrate this equation. After integration we get the equation. And now we come to here. You can see, you can check this equation relations. Del ri, what is here? Del ri. Since del ri is equal to 0 at end points, as you have assumed earlier in the beginning, so del ri is equal to 0 at end points, so it will be summation m ri dot. Now del w is equal to minus del v for conservative system, where v, what is v? V is the potential energy. So in place of del w, we use del v, so it will be minus del v plus del t. From here, it is del minus del v and plus del t. T is the kinetic energy. Now taking del common, t minus v, dt is equal to 0. T minus v is replaced by L because it is the Lagrangian function. So it will be L dt here. You can see L dt is equal to 0. And this is the Hamilton's principle. So we have deduced Hamilton's principle. Okay. I hope you have understood this question answer. If you have a problem, any problem, you may ask, you may contact through social sites, WhatsApp, Telegram, or with ever you may have any facility, you may contact. So thank you.